So when we are talking about the any types of viral infections or bacterial infections, because we know our both lungs right lung and left lung, both are very much important. We are continuously taking, breathe in, breathe out. We are doing this process regularly, continuously. And as per the acupuncture, we know lung has been told prime minister. Lung is prime minister of our body. And heart is the governor of body, that we know. And nowadays, all of you are in lots of worry because there is a virus. The name of that virus is coronavirus. Who is attacking our respiratory tract? So coronavirus is not a new virus. In 2003, we have seen the attack of SARS-CoV virus. Again, in 2012, we have seen, and we have told it, MERS. Now, in the 2019, again, we have seen the attack of SARS-CoV-2. And every time, it is affecting our lungs. But whether this virus affecting only lungs or the other body part also, we will shortly discuss. One of my doctor friend is suffering with the COVID-19 attack on the intestine, over the intestine. So he is running mucousy diarrhea multiple times, very foul smelling diarrhea multiple times. The same COVID-19 virus has attacked on the intestine. So let's proceed one by one. So what is the meaning of SARS-CoV? The meaning of SARS-CoV, S-A-R-S-C-O-V, S means severe, acute respiratory syndrome, and many of them add syndrome or disease. So this is one type of very, very severe, very, very acute attack on the respiration, which starts from the upper respiratory tract. Then it is affecting the whole lungs and the multi-organ failure as well. So now, how this virus is entering in the body? So let's see how virus looks like. So let's proceed and see how virus looks like. This virus is a crown-shaped virus. We can see this virus is having multiple crowns over the head. Am I clearly audible?
So can you hear us, sir?
I think so this virus having multiple crown. This virus is mainly made by four proteins. How to remember these four proteins? The four protein M, E, N, S, MENS. M protein, E protein, N protein, and S protein. The most aggressive, or we can tell, the leader is S protein. Who is going ahead? So this is the virus and S protein all around. So this virus is made by four proteins. And protein is a very important thing. We can see here. On the surface of virus, we can see this is the S protein here. But other than S, we are having multiple other proteins. So total, we are having 4 proteins in this virus. So from the outside, it looks like in this way. If we go and see from inside, so from inside, we can see like an empty ball. It is not empty. Now, shortly, we will fill multiple things inside. And this is the RNA. RNA is single wire RNA. Single-stranded RNA. If we see the DNA, DNA is like that. DNA is like that. It is having double wire. Like in the human body, we are DNA. We are having DNA in our chromosomes. But in the virus, we are having RNA. RNA is like a single virus, single wire. So we can see this is the multiple RNA here. What is the importance of RNA? See, even in our human body, if we take the DNA and putting some chemicals and converting in RNA, this process is called transcription. Transcription. If taking the DNA, if taking the double wire and separating the wire, so this is the DNA, one wire and second wire, and these all are attached like this. If we want to separate them with some procedure, so this procedure is called transcription. So transcription means doing the division of DNA in the RNA, in the two RNA. But this is already RNA, we can see here. And we don't have any machines, we don't have in our laboratories. It's very difficult to scan the RNA. We can scan the DNA, we can find out the DNA, but it's very difficult to scan the RNA because RNA is so micro, so subtle. So inside the virus, we can see this RNA, the genetic material. The RNA is the genetic material. And other than this RNA, you can see this is the like a the snack inside. This is a very bigger protein that is called nucleocapsid protein, N protein, N protein. And RNA is attached with this N protein. So we can see inside we are having N protein. And RNA is attached with this. And outside we are having spike protein, S protein. And we are having M protein, membrane protein. In this way, we are having 4 protein. And this 4 protein not only is available in this COVID-19, but this protein are available in the SARS-CoV virus who attacked in the 2003. That was also came from the China. Again in the 2012, that was from Saudi Arabia, MERS, SARS, MERS, then again SARS. Every 7 to 10 years, this virus is coming back in a different form. So right now we are fighting with the SARS-CoV-2, who started from the Wuhan, China in 2019. So this is the whole structure of RNA. Now the very, very, very difficult thing, if we want to make the vaccine, if we want to make the vaccine, how can we make the vaccine? For making the vaccine, first we should know the form, the genetic code of the virus. Without knowing the genetic code of the virus, how can we make the vaccine? So when this virus attacked in the China itself has given the viral code to the rest part of the world. So China is having so advanced technology. China is so developed in the virology. And because of that genetic code, now the many countries are developing multiple types of vaccines. If we don't know the genetic code, then it's really very difficult. First, it will take very long time to know the genetic code of the virus. And after that, developing the vaccination, developing the vaccines, it will be taking longer time. So this is the single-stranded RNA virus. So now we have seen the conversion of the DNA. If we want to convert DNA in the RNA, this process is called transcription. So converting the double-stranded DNA in the single-stranded RNA, this process is called transcription. And if we do opposite, what is the meaning of opposite? Collect RNA and do the opposite processes and make the DNA. So this is called reverse transcription. So nowadays, when we want to check whether virus is available in the body or not, we are doing RT-PCR. What is the meaning of RT? The meaning of RT is reverse transcription. First, we have to convert this RNA into DNA. Then only we can proceed. Then only we can investigate. So the first process is called reverse transcription. Now we have converted the RNA in the form of DNA. Now remaining work will So this process is called reverse transcription. And here, this is the process, PCR, we are doing. Our scientists are doing since longer time. So this process is called the PCR process. The PCR means polymerase chain reactions. And this process has been done in the laboratories since many times. Our scientists are doing this process since long time and has done many times. Preparing the multiple chains. So what is happening exactly? We are collecting the sample. We are collecting the sample from the nasopharyngeal area, like the area who is just on the backside of nose, that is nasopharyngeal area or oropharyngeal area. The area of pharynx, either just backside of the nose or just backside of the mouth, that is called nasopharynx or oropharynx. So we are collecting the swab from there. Then we are converting that RNA if they are present. So we are putting that swab in the machines and converting that in the DNA. So that is called reverse transcription. Then we are making the multiple copies. So this process can be understood in this way. If we talk about the RT-PCR. Like we can understand with the example of hand pump. All of us know what is hand pump. Suppose we want water and we are pumping the hand pump. So sometimes water will come just after pumping three times. Then we'll tell, oh, water is very near. Water is very, very near. Water is very near. The water level is very good. But sometime we are pumping 20 times, then water is coming. Then we'll tell, okay, water level is little down. Water level is little down, but okay. And sometime we are pumping 100 times. So even water is not coming. So we'll tell, oh, water level is too down. In the same way, what we're doing? So we are collecting the nasopharyngeal swab. We are putting the cotton, putting in the nostrils and mouth and taking till the pharynx, collecting the swab. Then we are putting it in the machine. So if there is a RNA, it will be converted in the DNA. So this process will be called reverse transcription. And we are making multiple copies. Or we can tell. Now we are rotating this web in the machine. How the we are like put the mosambi in the mixer, then the juice will come very fast. In the same way, if you rotate the machine three times, and the virus is detectable, then we'll tell this RT-PCR is positive, very highly positive. If you rotate the machine 20 times and it is detectable, we'll tell it is positive. If you rotate the machine 35 times and then virus is detectable, then we'll tell positive. So till the 35 times, if we rotate the sample in the machine, if we move the sample in the machine, like we are pumping the hand pump, so water is coming, like we are rotating the mixer for taking the juice, like you are putting the orange, so juice will come very fast, but putting some guava, so juice will come very late and very little. So till the 35, if we are rotating till the 35 and we can detect the this virus, then we'll tell RT-PCR is positive. But more than 35, then we'll tell this RT-PCR is negative. So this is one test. Either it is coming on the 20-time rotation or it is coming in the 3-time rotation. Sometime it happened, the infection is very little. Then virus will come very late. But after a few days, the infection will be very high. Then virus will come very fast. In that way, if RT-PCR positive, then we should start the treatment immediately. We will discuss as per acupuncture, how can we do the treatment. In the acupuncture, we are having treatment of every stage. So this is a reverse transcription, polymerase chain reactions. So this is called RT-PCR. So coming back to our previous point. So when coronavirus is infecting the normal person, see, this is the coronavirus. This one is the coronavirus, COVID-19 or SARS-CoV-2. So the coronavirus can enter in the inside the cell because the coronavirus is targeting the cell. So suppose this is the cell, maybe this is the cell of the nasal epithelium. Maybe it is a cell of lung alveoli. So when coronavirus is looking toward this cell, coronavirus is here and want to enter in this cell. So the coronavirus searching the door. There are many types of door on the boundary of cell. So this is the cell. Some door is called ACE. Some door is called ACE2. The meaning of ACE is angiotensin converting enzyme receptor. So this is the name of door. So this door has been made on the cell for balancing the blood pressure. The God has given this door. So as per need, we can reduce the BP or we can increase the BP. On the outside of the cell, we are having one door. The name of this door is ACE. This is useful for increasing the BP. So when body need to increase the BP, brain is secreting some chemical. They are entering from here and they are increasing the BP. On the other side, there is an ACE2 receptor cell. Receptor, they are for decreasing the BP. Suppose you are relaxing, you don't want to work more, just you want to relax, just you want to chill, you are in the holiday, then this ACE2 receptor is decreasing the BP, relaxing your body system. So now it is, even doctor, what doing? They are blocking this door, ACE door. If you block this door with the medicine, so they are giving some medicines. There are many, many medicines available. So when you go to your doctor, I am suffering with the high BP. So they will give you some medicine. They will block the ACE door. So the chemical who is responsible for increasing the blood pressure, they will not act. And in each and every cells of the body, the ACE receptor will be blocked. Then your BP will be always normal. If you put in the Google medicine, the medicine ACE blocker, then you will find the list. Maybe if someone is hypertensive, someone is taking the medicine of BP, they will find, then maybe they are taking this medicine. Who is blocking this door? ACE inhibitor. Okay. But ACE inhibitor is not our target. ACE is not our target. The corona is targeting ACE2 receptor. So the corona is reaching to the cell. So this is the cell. Corona reaching to the cell and introducing to the ACE2 receptor, like this virus belong to the cell only, introducing in this way. And the spike protein available on the outer surface of the corona is getting attached with this. So this is getting attached. And finally, it is doing entry from here. So look at another image. If you look at this image, so we can see this is the coronavirus, this is the COVID. And this one to take the entry, and this is the receptor, ACE2. And this is easily taking this corona inside with the feeling that this belongs to us. Now this is going inside, taking entry inside with the help of ACE2 receptor. Now as soon as going inside, now it is multiplying. As soon as you go inside, then searching the ribosome, because the ribosome is the Xerox machine. Ribosome is the Xerox machine inside the cell. So this COVID-19 will go to the ribosome and start multiplication and will increase in in lakhs quantity, and it will break the cell membrane and come out on the surface, ready to spread in the other cells. So look at here, the multiple coronavirus has broken down the cells and coming out, they're now ready to spread all around. So that's why when someone is suffering with the COVID-19, suffering with the hypoxia, multi-organ failure, and these are the cause of death. But the question comes, when coronavirus is attacking the person who is vaccinated, then how it work? So look at here, if person is already vaccinated or previously infected with the COVID, then our body will develop the antibodies. These green structure is antibodies here, and ready to fight, prepared antibody. If the person has got the COVID-19 infection and developed the antibodies, or the person is vaccinated and developed the antibodies, and when again this coronavirus is entering in the body, so as soon as it enters, our body is releasing the antibodies. Not only this, this is the immune cell, which is very dangerous to the COVID virus. On the one side, body is secreting the antibodies. On the other side, these immune cells are coming to damage the new entry of virus. So both together. So the antibodies is covering the COVID-19 virus, and because of this, the COVID-19 virus unable to take the entry with the help of this ACE2 receptor. On the other hand, this immune cell are coming and eating this viral particle completely. We can say, now viral particle got taken by the immune cells. So in this way, vaccination works very nicely if the person developed immunity. So the coronavirus is not the single virus. I have already told you, the coronavirus is a family, MERS, SARS, SARS-CoV-2, and it take the many the family members. Sometimes it take only 2 days, sometimes it is take only 14 days to create all the symptoms in the human body. So what are the symptoms created by this virus? So the first symptoms created by the virus, the upper respiratory tract infections. Then slowly it is creating influenza, pneumonia, respiratory failure, and multi-organ failure. So nowadays we know there are many medicines in the market. Some person is telling this medicine is very good, approved by DRDO. DRDO, all of you heard that. The medicine has been used previously for the cancer patient. In this medicine, the approved by DRDO, the 2-DZ, 2-deoxy, glucose. So what is the meaning of this? In the glucose particle, suppose this is the glucose particle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose this is the glucose particle. Maybe this right or chemically, what is the formula? You know better. So this is the, suppose this is the chemical formula of the glucose. On the second place, we are removing the oxygen. So it's a deoxy, without oxygen, deleting the oxygen from the second place. So it is called 2 means from the second place, D means deleting oxygen from the glucose. So if you delete the oxygen from the glucose, so this glucose become very strange type of glucose, and cells are not using this in the form of energy. So what is happening? So previously this has been used for the cancer treatment. Because cancer cells are not under control. They are continuously growing, growing, growing. And for this growth, they are consuming lots of glucose. So give the sachets of do this, because this is available in the form of sachet. So give the sachets of this deleted oxygen glucose, 2-deoxyglucose, in too much amount. So the cancer cell will die because they will not get the glucose, because main food of the cancer cells are glucose. They will get the energy from the glucose. They will multiply with the help of glucose. But the cancer cells are not getting this glucose. So how they will multiply? So they are dying. So same things has been used for the COVID. Because any virus also using the glucose for the multiplication, for the energy. So when you give this medicine to DZ, this COVID-19 virus also, in the laboratory, it has been seen that this virus is dying. But the most disadvantage of this, because we stop the glucose supply, because glucose is the very basic and main food of our body, then there will be lots of other damage. Lots of other damage. It is something like that you are breathing a polluted air. So we are blocking your nostrils. We are blocking your nostrils, because air is polluted. So this is still, this is the subject. Even we know that cancer patient is getting lots of side effects, lots of other bad effects in the body. Okay, so this was the, but there is one more question. What is the question? Body is not getting glucose, but is not using glucose in the form of energy, but is also using the protein, but is also using the fat. So this is the subject of research. That whether this will not give the energy? Let's see. So in this DRDO approval, especially this medicine has been given because this medicine is stopping the glucose supply. So many of you are thinking that I'm not discussing about what is the role of acupuncture. So don't worry. That is our main topic. We will discuss the role of acupuncture as well. Before that, nowadays, there are multiple vaccines are available. Because we know what are the questions in the human mind. So I am discussing that all questions. Some vaccine is inactivated virus. In some vaccine, this is the very old pattern of the vaccination. This is a very old pattern of the vaccination that take the whole virus, make it completely inactivated, and use in the form of vaccination. Like in this theme, India and China has developed vaccines. India has developed Covaxin, that is a deactivated virus. China also have developed Sinovac. That is also deactivated virus. So the India and China has developed the vaccination on the old pattern. But this is also effective. Now, next technique of the developing the vaccination is viral vector. Viral vector. What is viral vector? The viral vector means like Covishield. Covishield is like Sputnik V from the Russia. And Covishield is manufacturing, the manufacturer is India, but this is the technology of UK. UK and Sweden. And the Sputnik V is from the Russia. They are using this viral vector technique. So what is the viral vector technique? Even Johnson and Johnson, who is claiming that single dose is enough? Who is also using this viral vector? Johnson & Johnson belong to the US and Belgium. So in this way, Covishield is working on the viral vector formula. Sputnik working on the viral vector formula. Johnson & Johnson working on the viral vector formula. So what is viral vector formula? What is that? The viral vector formula is, either you take any, you can take the virus, the virus who is causing common cold. The virus who is causing common cold, like adenovirus, which is not much harmful. Because the main problem with the vaccine manufacturing is, if you develop the original virus, then it is really very dangerous, because you have to develop the virus. You have to kill the strength of the virus. It is not the easy task. So this task is look little easy, like we are taking some other virus who is little weaker, so we can grow without any discomfort. So either we take the virus from the chimpanzee, like it has taken in the Covishield, or take the virus of the human common cold. So taking the virus means, suppose this is the outer sheath of the virus. This is the outer sheath of the adenovirus. And inside we are putting the genetic material of COVID-19. So in the normal virus, inside we are putting the genetic code of COVID-19, and we are entering this virus so that we can easily manufacture this, because this is not much harmful. Because the dangerous thing is spike protein around the shield. Okay, so this is the adenovirus technology. In the Covishield, they have taken the chimpanzee virus. And the Sputnik V, they have taken human common cold virus. Even if we talk about the Johnson & Johnson, they have taken human virus. And all are claiming 70%, 90%, 80%. So see, if we want to grow this technique, it is a little easier. But there is one disadvantage of this technique also. Let's see what. So suppose this is the human. Who is already attacked by some adenovirus earlier. Like, because all of us are suffering with common cold very frequently. We know that. Even if doctor who is working in the hospital, they are always in the contact with the multiple virus. So they are getting multiple attacks. Many person are living in the hospital campus or nearby the hospitals. So they are facing all the virus all the time. So what is happening? They are getting attacked by multiple common cold virus. So not only doctors, all the health cares, and any person who is get attacked by multiple common cold virus. And suppose body has developed the antibodies. Body already has developed the antibodies. Now, if scientist is taking the same adenovirus, and inside that they are putting the genetic code of the COVID, then when they inject, body already having immunity, because body immunity system is fighting, because they will recognize this adenovirus spike protein this adenovirus already has attacked 2 years back. I have already immune cells. We have already antibodies. We will fight. We will throw it back. So there will no new antibody generation. That's why many people, even after the attack of, even after the immunization, they are dying. Why they are dying? Because even after injecting the vaccine, even after doing the vaccination, body is not developing the new antibodies. Body is throwing out that vaccination because the person already has antibodies. In this way, so every vaccination having some disadvantage. So this is a very big disadvantage of this vaccination. How can you rule out? How can you find out that this person is not attacked by this type of virus? We are already, since the childhood, we are getting multiple attacks. Every time we are getting attacks, but our immune system fighting them. Now, third vaccination is on the mRNA technique. mRNA. That is very advanced and new technique. And all the very developed countries like US, we already know US made the vaccines on the mRNA technique. The Pfizer and Biotech. And not only this, even Moderna, they have developed. And the medicine has been claimed, even it can be injected, it can be taken in the form of nasal spray. What is mRNA technique? Whether India is also doing something? So there's very good news. India also has developed one mRNA vaccines, and it is under trial. No, trial is going to start very soon. The name of mRNA vaccines of India. India is working very nicely. HGCO19. This is also on the mRNA. mRNA is a very newly advanced technology, and it is very safe to grow in the laboratory. Why? So for that, we have to understand one thing. See, this is the DNA. If you break down the DNA and convert in the RNA, so this is the DNA. You break down the DNA and convert in the RNA. This process is called transcription. So we have already discussed, if you do reverse, that is called reverse transcription. Now, if you break down the RNA and make the multiple proteins, this process is called translation. Translation. So making the protein. So when we want to get the energy, energy coming in this way only. DNA is getting converted in the RNA, messenger RNA. Then RNA is getting converted in the form of protein. So now, so remember the translation. Translation. So what we are doing, take the RNA, we are telling mRNA, messenger RNA. Who is having message of? Because RNA is the genetic material, and the real information is in the genetic material only. So suppose this is the king who is sitting inside, and this is the army who is outside. The king is giving the order and army is fighting, and army is doing lots of damage. This army is doing lots of damage. RBs outside in the corona. So what we are doing, we are just taking the inner material. We are just using the inner material. Because inside the coronavirus, the corona is not having DNA. 1 minute. So RNA is, the virus is not having DNA. Like in the human body, we are having DNA. But in the virus having RNA. So we are just using the RNA and the just very inactivated part of the RNA. Because RNA is having information. RNA is having all the things. So we are taking mRNA and directly injecting in the human body. So what we are doing, we are taking the RNA, we are packing it very nicely, then injecting. So when RNA is going in the human body, we already know RNA is making the protein. This process is called translation. And this RNA is having information to all, like how many protein I have in my corona body, how many protein is there, how many protein is here, how the coronavirus look like. This all information is there in the RNA. So we are just leaving all the army, just we are taking the king and entering in the body. And not only, not full king, the king is very like, we are damaging the body of king also. So king also cannot harm. So the king is entering in the body without the army. Now king is going inside and making the protein, because now king want to make the army. As soon as it make the protein, this is, so brain will see something wrong. So brain buildup, this protein is work like an antigen, then brain develop the antibodies. So this is a very safe technique, leaving the army, just entering the king inside the human body. So this technique is mRNA based. And the many of country are working on this technology. Nowadays, this is a very advanced technology. Even India is ready to launch our mRNA vaccines shortly. So we will not suffer with the monopolies of the Pfizer company, of the Moderna company. And this medicine can be taken even by nasal spray. So let's see. So right now we are having three medicine in the India. One Covaxin, second Covishield, third Sputnik V. The Covishield, Covaxin is inactivated virus. Covishield is viral vector. Inside, so in the chimpanzee virus, inside we are having the corona material. This is the viral vector. And Sputnik V is also in the same pattern, viral vector. But we are having human virus, human adenovirus. The good thing of the Sputnik, this is in the powder form. So the life is long. And these two are in the liquid form. Okay, there will be many more vaccines will be launched shortly in the future. So let's see what acupuncture think about this. As per the acupuncture, when virus is want to attack and want to take the entry from the ACE2 receptor. Then body creates some symptoms. There are many symptoms appear in the body. So Wuhan Hospital of China. Has given the very good guideline of the acupuncture. And as per the Wuhan School of China, there are 4 stages of the corona attack or COVID-19 attack. The first is called prevention phase. How to prevent our body? How to make our body so that the virus cannot infect us? Second is influenza phase or flu phase. The flu phase means that the first symptom when you are telling, oh, I'm suffering with a common cold, I'm feeling throat infection, I'm feeling laryngitis, pharyngitis, sore throat, my nose is running. So I am feeling feverish, low-grade fever, shivering. These all are the influenza first phase. We can even stop the infection here. Third is called pneumonia phase, which is a little danger. Even we can prevent the infection here. And final is, after crossing this, because pneumonia phase having multiple, moderate pneumonia, severe pneumonia, critical pneumonia, if we cross this phase, then finally we will reach on the recovery phase. So we will discuss the treatment of every phase. We are going to discuss the treatment of every phase, whatever possible in this short time. Today and tomorrow, we will discuss. So let's talk about the prevention phase first. So these are the 4 phases we can see here. There are 4 phases of the viral infections. When somebody is calling me, doctor, I'm suffering with the flu, I'm suffering with a throat infection. So I am giving them these points only, which we'll discuss. And in last many months, most of the patient has recovered. Only few patients were treated by me, and many patients just treated themselves, because some belong to North India, some belong to South India. Even in my family member, some of people suffered with the primary symptoms. I immediately called me and I told them, okay, put these points, I am sending you image, do the treatment on this point. And within 24 hours, they are feeling improvement. So if we follow these 4 phases very nicely, if we know the treatment of the viral attack in these 4 phases, then we can work very nicely. So let's proceed for the first phase. The first phase is called prevention phase. Which one is the beautiful atmosphere for the corona? If the body having lots of turbid kapha, turbid phlegm, if body is having lots of turbid phlegm, then this is the favorable atmosphere of the corona. What is turbid phlegm? How will you know that you are having turbid phlegm or not? I will tell you one example. Suppose you are taking your dinner or lunch. after taking lunch or dinner, if you are feeling sleepy, then you are having turbid kapha, turbid phlegm. You will tell, oh, but everyone feels sleepy. No. Whoever feels sleepy after taking the meal, they are having turbid phlegm. Even in the Ayurveda, it has been told, then when you are eating the meal, leave some part of the stomach empty, at least 1/4 part of the stomach should be empty. Number two, don't drink water till the 40 minute, because if you're drinking the water immediately after the meal, it will make the turbid phlegm. And if you're sleeping every time after the meal, it will make the turbid phlegm, and the turbid phlegm will invite the bacteria, virus, because it is a favorable atmosphere of the body. Second thing, if your body is acidic, then it will be the second favorable atmosphere of the viral infections. So when virus is attacking in your body, it is decreasing the oxygen level, it is increasing the carbon dioxide level, because carbon dioxide creating the acidity in the body, which is the very favorable atmosphere of the virus. We know the person suffering with the hypoxia. The decreasing the oxygen level and increasing the CO2 level in the human body, that is a sign of acidic body. If your body is alkaline, if you are less acidic, then your body is not favorable atmosphere for the virus or bacteria. So our first duty, if you are having turbid phlegm, immediately do something to remove the turbid phlegm. Do something. If you are having acidic body, then do something to reduce the acidity, acidic level of your body immediately. Second, nourish the yin. What is the meaning of this nourishing the yin? Very important thing, nourishing the yin. So nourishing the yin means, suppose you are a leader, you are a very intellectual person, you are a very intellectual guy, or you are having very hectic day, very hectic lifestyle. You are working throughout the day, throughout the night, you are working till late night, 12 o'clock, 2 a.m. in the night. So just working, working, working. Then what will happen? So in your body, you are having, so suppose this is the one earthen pot. In the earthen pot, you are having, this is the oil, and you are having full of oil. This is the oil. Now you are igniting the flame. So this is the flame. So flame will be there only if oil will be there. If oil is not there, then you can't imagine the flame in the same way. Suppose someone is walking day and night. So he is igniting multiple flame, and the oil is decreasing. The level of oil is decreasing. In the acupuncture, this is called jing. In the India, we are telling it virya, virya. Jing or virya. So jing and virya is the essence of the human body. So during the day, when we are walking, we are converting this jinga virya in the form of phlegm. And in the night, we are sleeping nicely, we are resting nicely. And again, we are filling our earthen pot with the jing. So during the day, we are igniting the flame using the jing. And during the night, we are sleeping nicely. And we are again filling this jing. Not only with the sleeping, even we do meditation, we do yoga nidra, and we eat a very good and nutritious food. If we eat a very good and nutritious food, then also we are filling this earthen pot with the jing. So if your earthen pot is full of jing, then we are telling you are having good yin. But if you have consumed, because you are a leader, you are a very intellectual person, you are having the OPD of 150 patients per day, so you are working morning to night, you don't have time to eat, you don't have time to sleep, you don't have time to rest, so your jing get consumed. Flame is still very high because you are a So what will happen? Yin is too less. Now, this is the favorable atmosphere for the corona virus. Not only corona, for any virus. Because this yin is your immunity. So the person who sleep nicely, who relax nicely, who do meditation properly, they suffer less with the many infections. I have seen many person who is doing regular meditation, regular dhyan, sadhana, pranayama in a very proper way. They are getting very less corona. So the most important thing is nourishing the yin. Yin should be very good. How to nourish? Take the proper sleep. Do the yoga nidra, pranayama. And in the acupuncture, it has been given. We have to tonify 3 points, stomach 36, CV6, and CV12. With the help of these points, we can nourish the yin. Stomach 36 also has been told the steroid point. What is the meaning of a steroid? It is not that steroid who suppress our immunity. This is the natural steroid, the body steroid, who gives too much endurance, power, and enthusiasm. So we do the tonification of the stomach 36, and we can strengthen the chi. So stomach 36 is very good to strengthen the chi. And what about the CV6? CV6 is the very nice point to improve the chi. CV6 is one of the very good point to improve the chi. And CV12 we are using for improving the chi as well as yin. There may be many points, but as per the Wuhan Hospital of the China, these 3 points has been given. So they have told, do the regular moxa on these 3 points. With the help of moxa, you will able to remove your turbid flame, unwanted deposition of the flame. When this flame is occupying your heart, you feel heaviness in the heart. You feel, I'm not feeling good enough. You suffer with the mania, mental ups and downs. When this flame, turbid flame, occupy your brain, you suffer with the neurological problems. So this turbid flame is creating lots of physical and mental disorders. So with the help of these 3 points, if you do the moxivation at these 3 points, you can remove the turbid flame and you can nourish the chi and you can nourish the yin. And even if some person having some problem, then we can diagnose and we can also add the point. But right now, this is the common point which everyone should do. The moxie mission at 3 points. So let's see the location of all the 3 points. The stomach 36 point is found in the stomach meridian. So look at the location of the stomach 36. If you see this knee, so this is the knee joint. And this is the knee eye. The knee eye means stomach 35. If we go 3 chun down, 3 chun means 4 finger down. So how can we measure? We can keep the 4 finger here. So finger number 1, finger number 2, finger number 3, and finger number 4. If we keep our 4 finger here, from this eye, from the stomach 36, so 4 finger or 3 chun down, we are having the location of stomach 36. Let's see once again, because this is a very important point. If we see in this image, in the lower leg, we are having 2 bones. The inner bone is called tibia and the outer bone is called fibula. In these 2 bones, we are having gap in between. So on the border of this tibia bone, we are having location of the stomach 36. It is a really wonderful point. Even someone is suffering with the knee pain because of the osteoarthritis. If the person do regular moxivation, regular moxa here, then every day he or she will feel very good. Just do the moxivation on the stomach 36. It will bring more energy in your knee area. So this is the first point. Do the moxivation here. Remove the turbid phlegm, unwanted phlegm. No need to. Then don't worry for any infection, because any virus can attack in a body when he get the turbid phlegm, weaker yin, poor chi. But now it's not possible for the virus. So we can do the 10 to 12 minutes or 10 to 15 minutes moxivation every day. And if there is a too much corona or everywhere, even you can do twice a day. I hope all of you are aware with the moxivation. So I'm not doing the demonstration of the moxivation, and I'm going ahead for the next point. If anyone is having any doubt in the moxivation, then he can ask me later. I can give you some videos of the moxivation. Then you can see the video and do the moxivation. So if anyone having any doubt, he can send me request. I can send the video on your personal number. The second point is CV6 and CV12. So let's see. If you see the navel region, from the navel region, if we go just 2 finger down, 1 finger and 2 finger. So just if we go 2 finger down, or it is called 1.5 chun. So this is the place which is really very wonderful. We can put the red color if we want to improve the energy. If you want to improve the energy, just put the red color here. Just by putting the red color here, you will get good energy. You will able to improve energy, or you needle this point and definitely do the moxa here. Moxa here. The person who is suffering with the high blood pressure, the person who is always very angry, so they should do the moxivation. They should do, and they should also be careful that whether they are getting more anger, whether they are getting the BP. If BP is increasing, then don't do this point. Because this point is increasing too much energy, even it may increase BP. If person is already hypertensive, but for the normal person, it will not touch your BP. It will just improve your energy level. Even this point is very good for improving your fertility, for for your sperm count. This point is very good for your ovary, for fertility, for male and female genital problem, CV6. The CV6 is directly connected with our sex chakra, Swadhisthana chakra, and CV6 is directly connected with governing vessel, our Mingmen chakra. So the CV6 is one of the wonderful points for improving the chi. So this is the second point. Do the 10 to 12 in moxivation. Now third and final point. From the navel region, if we go four chun up, one chun, one chun, one chun, and one chun, four chun. And we know what is the one chun. Meaning of one chun, suppose this is the thumb. The width of the joint of thumb, that is one chun. If we take the thumb and measure the width of the thumb, that is one chun. So from the navel, if we go four chun up, that is the CV12 point, one of the very wonderful points, CV12. Why CV12 is very wonderful? So before telling about the CV12, I will tell you, we have to do the moxivation here also. We can needle these three points, 1-2 and stomach 36, bilateral. So from the navel, if we go 1.5 chun down, that is CV6. From the navel, if we go four chun up, that is CV12. Why CV12 is very wonderful point? CV12 is not the ordinary point. It is really very wonderful point. The CV12 is improving the stomach as well as the spleen. Spleen is connected with our phlegm and unwanted deposition of kapha. Unwanted deposition of kapha. Spleen is connected. As per the acupuncture, it is clearly has been told, if your spleen is good, then it will make the energy. But if spleen is poor, it will make the phlegm or kapha. And it is also has been told, spleen, the poor spleen make phlegm. Then it get deposited in lungs, in heart, in many other part. So who is forming the phlegm? Poor spleen is forming the phlegm. If your spleen is good, then now who will form the phlegm? No one. So making the spleen good, and how to make the spleen good? For making the spleen good, the stomach 36 and CV12 moxivation is wonderful. They are making your spleen stronger. Spleen is stronger, no further formation of the phlegm. If someone is suffering with a phlegm, just try today and tomorrow morning. Within two sittings, you will feel wonderful. Just do the moxivation of the stomach 36, CV12, and add CV6 also. You will also feel good energy. So CV12 is improving the stomach as well as the spleen. In the acupuncture, it has been told the CV12 is the alarm point of stomach. If any problem happened in the stomach, then CV12 will be painful. If you treat the CV12, then stomach problem will go away. And nowadays, all of us are suffering with the stomach problem. Even it has been told the CV12 is the minister or influential point of stomach as well as all other yang meridian. So if there is a problem in the stomach, we will use CV12. But not only this, if there is a problem in the small intestine, triple warmer, gallbladder, urinary bladder, as well as the large intestine, these all organ also can be improved just by CB12. See, what a wonderful point. You are just stimulating the single point CB12. It is improving your stomach plus small intestine plus triple warmer plus gallbladder plus urinary bladder for large intestine, because it is the influential point of these all. It will influence all the young organ. So that's why, if you do the moxibustion for 10 minutes on the CB12, if you are having some turbid phlegm in the large intestine, it will be removed. Then your large intestine will be cleared. Urinary bladder will be cleared, so you will not get urinary stone or urinary tract infection in the future. The gallbladder will be cleared, the triple warmer will be cleared, and the small intestine will be cleared just by CB12 point. So CB12 is the not ordinary point. So CB6, CB12, and stomach 36, do the moxibustion all these in these all points. Just you should avoid the moxibustion in the condition if you are already having excessive anger, excessive heat in the body. That time do tonification. How to do tonification? You can do the tonification with the needles in the original point. I have demonstrated. Even you can go in the sujog. How to do in the sujog? I will also demonstrate in the sujog, because many of you have requested me that I should also demonstrate points on the sujog. So let's see this image. 1 minute. Yeah. So look at this image. Now, these are the sujog points. Because we know the CV meridian is going in the central body, central line. So in this image also we can see this is the line of CV meridian. And this is the CV6 point. And this is the CV12 point. So just we have to put the bowel magnet here. Or we can put the sujog needle here. So you put the sujog needle here, or you put the bowel magnet here, do the tonification. So this is the CB6 and this is the CB12. Suppose you don't have anything, then you can do that with the fingers. The right index finger. The right index finger in the male, do the tonification. If you are a male, then keep your right index finger on the CB6, it will be tonified for one to three minutes. Then keep your right index finger on the CV12, it will be tonified. Because right index finger having north pole, it is doing the tonification. But if you are a female, then use your left index finger. With the help of left index finger, you can do the tonification. So if you want to tonify CV6, put the right index finger tip. It will do tonification. So we are having multiple method of doing the tonification. In this way, we can use the bowel magnet, we can use the needles, or we can do the moxa here as well. Do the moxibustion in the sujog point on the CB6 and CB12. Let's see the location of CB, stomach 36. Stomach 36 is also a very wonderful point. So look at this location, look at this image. In the sujog, in the middle finger is like our leg. And we know the stomach meridian is going like this. And the middle finger can be divided in three joints. So the middle joint is the knee joint. And below, just 1 millimeter down from this line, this is the location of stomach 36. You can do the moxibustion here and tonification here. So you can see the chart. If you have chart, see the chart and put. If you don't have chart, send me request, I will send you. Send me request, I will send you the chart. So these sujog points also working. So just remember CB6, CV12 and stomach 36 and do the tonification. Do the moxivation. Put the magnet for the purpose of tonification. In this way, we can work in this phase. So this is prevention phase only. In the next phase, patient will come or our family member will suffer. They will tell you, oh, can you treat my tonsillitis? We will treat immediately. Can you treat my pharyngitis? We will treat immediately. We are having wonderful point. With a single point, we will remove the throat infection. We will discuss. So that is the influenza phase. But right now, our target to remove the turbid phlegm, improve the qi, strengthen the qi. So when we do this, so we can strengthen the qi, we can improve the yin. Now, today we have discussed till here. Now time is over. So thank you so much. Now, if anyone have any questions, so please, you can ask me. 1 minute.
Hello, sir. Good evening, sir. Thank you for the beautiful session, sir. Well explained. Even though we are not aware of this acupuncture much, very, very beautiful explanation. Even a layman can understand. Thank you so much, sir. And my doubt is, like you are telling about this BP, and even if they're very angry, you can keep the points in CV6, I guess, right? CV6 or CV12, right? But it is, if you give moxa for a BP patient, it is not good, no, sir. So the patient is having a BP and very angry, so we should not give the moxa for them.
I will tell. Once I start, then I cannot listen to you. So I will finish, then I will come back. Okay, fine. Okay. So
for the blood pressure patient, we should not do moxa on the CV6. Remember, I am repeating again. For the blood pressure patient, we should not do moxa on the CV6 because CV6 is the place of tremendous energy. CV6 is the place of like a... If you do the moxivation on the CV6, it will improve the tremendous yang energy. It will remove the turbid phlegm and improve the tremendous yang energy. So the person who is already having BP, they may get little more BP, but stomach 36, you can do moxa. And on the CV12, you can do moxa. But another thing, another condition, if the person having suffering with the yin deficiency, in the yin deficiency, moxa is not advisable. If you don't know what is yin deficiency, then I will explain you. Now you can ask.
Yes, sir. Please explain us the yin deficiency. How to find a yin deficiency in a person? For example, you said if a person is sleeping in the afternoon, then he is having such a phlegm and this thing. So similarly for us, the person is having a less yin energy, how to find it out?
So first I will tell you.
Not only this, just one sign of turbid phlegm, the person is sleeping, feeling sleepy just after having the meal, then it is a sign of turbid phlegm. But the main thing is this, there are lots of signs. Suppose one lady is quarreling with the husband and she is feeling lots of suffocation on the chest. So this is the turbid phlegm on the heart. So we can remove the turbid phlegm. We have to remove the turbid phlegm. So it is in acupuncture, it is given, put the small intestine 1 point and remove the turbid phlegm from the heart. One male person is having schizophrenia. So there is a phlegm in the heart and the brain. So in the acupuncture, phlegm is having two types. One is visible, one is invisible. So this theory is very subtle. And just I am trying to explain you. This is the phlegm means who is creating turbidness, dirtiness, and some unhygienic atmosphere in some places. And it not only one thing like sleeping in the afternoon, this sleeping in the afternoon is one sign, but there is a lots of other signs. Like one person is telling, I'm not feeling good enough. That is turbid phlegm. So we have to remove it. Now, next question, how to find out yin deficiency? Suppose one person is working throughout the day, having very good energy, is very good leader and a very good commander. In the night, he is not sleeping more than 3 hours or 4 hours because he is doing lots of work till the 2 a.m. or till the 12 p.m. in the night. So he is doing 1 day this thing, 2 day this thing, and many months, then many years. Then what is happening? The cooling system of the body, the air condition of the body get damaged or get disturbed because night is a air condition. When we are sleeping in the night, our body spray the cooling effect in each and every organ. So each and every organ become cool and calm and quiet. They get relaxed. So this happened in the night. But if the person is not getting enough relaxation, even he's and many other person, they are having enough time to sleep, but they are not getting the sleep because of some problem. So in that condition also, the air condition of the body is getting disturbed. So what sign they are feeling? Number one, dry throat. Dry throat may not be there. I am telling once again. So what sign they are getting? Thirst and dry throat. Both may be there. Second, hot palm, hot sole, hot chest, red cheeks. So they are feeling heat, like something like waves of heat floating from top to bottom, bottom to top. And evening time, they are feeling very dull, very feverish. So if someone is feel very dull and feverish in the evening time, it is a sign of yin deficiency.
Okay, thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Dr. Uma?
Yeah, thank you, madam. Good evening, sir. Thanks for the wonderful session. Sir, I have two questions. One is like you are telling like ST36, we have to like tonification, first thing. And again, CV6 and CV12. So how long we have to do moksha or tonification here, sir? And you are telling like for males, we have to do on right hands.
No. Yeah. Okay. Done?
Yeah, sir.
So one thing I
am unable to pass the proper message to you, but I did not.
Okay, so
you should do in the right hand of the male. You can do. Okay. You can do in any hands, like you should do in the both hands of the male and female both. Number two, the first you told me how long time as per the Wuhan hospital of China protocol, they have told during the pandemic. We should do twice a day, at least 10, 12, or till 15 minute moxibation, like we at every point. I know this is very difficult, but what we can do, we can take the moxa, we do on the CV12, then CV6, then stomach 36, then CV12, then CV6, then then stomach 36. In this way, we can do at least 15 minute, but the Wuhan hospital, they have told you should do the moxibation at every point, at least for 10 to 12 minutes.
Okay. Sir, is it like almost normally like after food 1 hour, no, sir?
Yes, definitely. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Fine. Thank you so much, sir.
So now some questions from the chat box, sir. Can we put red color in a CV12 point?
Lalita, madam, can you see my notepad where I collectively given the question?
Yeah, from that only I have read it out right now.
Thank you so much.
Okay. See, you can see the text and then all the questions you can.
Yeah, I can read. Okay. So the question number one, I'm reading one. Okay. Yeah. So the question number one.
Can we put the red color on the CB12? See, the concept of color therapy is very, very like deep. Definitely, you can put the red color on the CV12 point. But if you think that with the red color, we can tonify all the points, this concept is not perfect. Definitely, on the CV12, you can put the red color and you can do the tonification. But see, if you tonify the coldness, then you have to do the black color. If you tonify the heat, then you have to do the red color. So what we want to tonify in the body, if we want to tonify the yin in the body, suppose we want to improve the yin, we want to tonify the yin, then we have to use the black color. So if we want to tonify the yang, then we have to put the red color. So just with the help of red color, we cannot keep on doing the tonification everywhere. Suppose I am working on the kidney. I am putting the black color on the kidney 6. So I am doing the tonification. Okay. But instead of that, if I put the red color on the kidney 6, I am doing the sedation. Okay. So just do not think all the time the red color for the tonification and the black color or blue color for the sedation. But right now I can tell you CV12, you can put the red color. Okay. Any alternate for moxibustion? Yes. The alternate of moxibustion, first thing I would like to tell you, moxibustion is a very simple procedure. It is something like igniting a stick and doing the moxibustion. It's the very, very simplest procedure. If you don't know, you can send me request. I will post one video for you. It's very simple. I think every should learn this. Second thing, if you don't want to do the moxibustion, then definitely I already told you, do the tonification. Tonification is other thing. How long we need to do per day? I already told you 10, 12 or 15 minutes. CV12 in how will it strengthen the chi? I already told the CV12 is the influential point of stomach of all the yang organ. So it is improving the chi in all the yang organ. Which color to use in bowel points? Again, the question I told, you can use red color here. How many times moxibustion have to do in the day and how many times? As per the Wuhan Hospital of China, at least 2 times a day. But what I think, practically it becomes very difficult. At least you do single 1 time a day. What is the best point for the dry cough due to body heat? I will tell you after reading all this. Can we do the moxa in the evening, at night? Any restriction on timing? No any restriction if you are having some problem. But if you are okay, then do in the during the daytime. Suppose if you do the moxibustion, so sometimes yang energy becomes so high, then you may feel disturbed sleep, because for sleeping nicely, you need yin energy. Okay. Question?
Done. Any more question? Okay, so there is no question, so I will reply the answer. Okay, I will reply
the answer for the question that how can we treat the dry cough? How can we treat the dry cough? So I am replying. I cannot hear you because I am speaking right now. If you have any questions, so as soon as I stop, then you can ask the question. Okay, so the question is, how can we treat the dry cough? So listen carefully. We are already going to discuss how to treat the dry cough in the recovery phase, because we are having 4 phases: prevention, flu, pneumonia, and recovery. In the recovery phase, we are already having the treatment of dry cough. But right now, if someone needs, then I can give you direct protocol. For the dry cough, you have to improve the lung energy with the help of lung 9, with the help of urinary bladder 13. So for the treatment of dry cough, lung 9, urinary bladder 13, spleen 6, kidney 6. These 4 points are the main point. You can do the tonification. I'm repeating again. Spleen 6 and kidney 6 will improve the level of fluid, because in the dry cough, dryness is there because fluid is very less. So with the help of spleen 6 and kidney 6, we can improve the fluid, and with the help of lung 9 and urinary bladder 13 point, we can tonify the lung. So with the help of these 4 points, we can treat the dry cough. I will add a few more points when I will discuss the recovery phase. Okay? Now.
Hello.
Hello.
Can I ask one question, sir? Sir, I had first vaccination, and that was COVID shield. And after that, my hand was swollen up very badly, and it was swollen very, very bad. After 2-3 days, it reduced. Now, almost 1.5 months has passed, Now there is no swelling, but when I lift up my hand to a middle like little up from the ground, parallel like to the ground, there is a pain still in a particular muscle, like an stiffness and any, like, why this or how can it be treated? After 1.5 months of it also, I have that. I had very high fever after the vaccine. And why does this fever and all, so high fever and so much? Some people don't get any reaction. Some people, I got very bad reaction of the vaccine.
Okay, fine. So
what has happened? Many person are getting some pain, some, this is called inflammation. See, what is inflammation? Inflammation is a, when, see, what is inflammation? Try to understand this thing. When any virus or bacteria attacking on the body, your body, and your body is fighting with it. So the fighting is going on. Even the vaccination, in the vaccination, there is a very poor strength virus. But even that body is fighting and preparing the antibodies. So during this fighting, there's a redness, there is a heat. These all things are called inflammation. So you are having pain because of the inflammation. So you have to do the treatment that is called anti-inflammatory. What is the treatment? Who is anti-inflammatory? Very simple treatment, do the bleeding from the ear apex. If you do the bleeding from the ear apex, so you will remove the immediate inflammation. And I have done my video on the YouTube just for the treatment of inflammation. You can search Hemant Sharma inflammation video, or you can send me request, I will send you. So you have to put 4 to 5 points in the ear to reduce the inflammation, do the ear apex bleeding, and listen very carefully. Always, whenever you are falling down or whenever you are having any types of inflammation, so first you have always put 4 points, that is called 4-gate, liver 3 bilateral and Li4 bilateral. Repeating again, liver 3 bilateral, Li4 bilateral, this combination is called 4-gate. This is removing all types of inflammation, unwanted blockages of the energies because of the inflammation, because of the sports injury, and because of the anything. So you can put the 4-gates. Even there are many other treatment of the inflammation, but right now I will suggest you 4-gates, liver 3 and Li4 bilateral, and I will suggest you one auricular point protocol, which is already there in the YouTube, where the most important thing, the bleeding from the ear apex. If you do the bleeding from the ear apex today, after 1 hour, you will feel very lightness in your arm. So you search or you send me request, I will send you.
Any question?
JNBM.
Sir, very good evening, sir, and it was a very wonderful session, sir. I just need to know this Biol magnet, which color to be faced, to be kept on the hand, on the palm. And the other thing is, you're talking about vaccination. So when now, because as we are staying in the south of Chen of Tamil Nadu, nowadays the Sputnik is coming forward. So, I mean, I have a few ailments. I have GRED and I have TB. So, is it advisable to go in for?
Okay. Yeah. So, first I will
reply for the magnets. So, I will share my screen so that you can understand. Okay. No screen. Okay, I will tell you. See, when we're talking about the magnets. So, okay. And now I can share my screen. Fine. So look at this image. Suppose this is the stomach meridian. And this middle finger can be divided in 3 parts. This is the upper joint, this is the middle joint, this is the lower joint. And here we are having stomach 36. Now I want to tonify this point. So I will take the Buell magnet. The Buell magnet having two types. If you see the Buell magnet on the one side, it is looking like yellow. Okay, on the one side, it is looking like yellow. So suppose I am making Buell magnet here. See, 1 minute. So Buell magnet on the one side, it is looking like yellow. On the other side, it is white. Okay. So when we put on the skin, when we are putting on the skin, so this Buell magnet having one side yellow, other side white. Suppose I am putting on the skin. I am taking this Buell magnet here. Now I will take this yellow magnet and I am taking it. Other side is white. And I am putting here on the stomach 36. This is the sedation. Sedation. If I can see, after putting the magnet, I can see yellow from the top. This is called sedation. On the other side, if I can see the yellow. On the other side, if I can see the white. Suppose I can see the white. If I'm putting the Buell magnet and I can see the white from the top, not yellow. Not yellow. But I can see the white. Then it is called tonification. Because I am doing the graphical presentation, maybe it is clear. Second thing about the vaccination. So if you can see the white from the top, that is tonification. And yellow from top, that is sedation. Okay, next thing about the Sputnik vaccine. Sputnik V. See, this vaccine is really very good. Why? I will tell you the reason. One, this vaccine is not having the real virus. The outer covering is adenovirus, the simple virus, the simple human common cold virus, which is harmless and which is not creating much problem. Body is always getting lots of harm because of this part of the COVID-19. Inside we are having the real material, but this is also in the very big form. So when they will inject this medicine, this will not do much harm. Like this will not do any harm because outside is normal common cold virus. Inside we are having RNA. And the very good thing with the Sputnik is there are two vaccinations. The first vaccination and after a few days there is second vaccination. Both the vaccination, they are using different outer covering. Suppose if they insert these vaccines to you and your body is developing the antibodies, then in the second dose when they insert this next vaccination, your body will fight this vaccine, expelled it out. In the both time, they are doing the different types of virus, but inner material is same. So your body will develop very good amount of antibodies. So this is very safe and the life is very good. Because other vaccines, sometimes maybe you are taking, but this vaccine is not working properly because that is in the liquid form and that required very good temperature. Like all the Indian medicines are not required that much low temperature, but a Sputnik vaccine is really good because it is in the powder form. and the life is very long, and it is absolutely safe. So nothing to worry for this. This is on the Bacter formula. So nothing to worry this. Go ahead and take.
Any other question?
Yes, good evening. Thank you very much for your lovely session. Hello, can you hear me?
One minute. I want to interrupt you.
Sorry, because someone has got wrong message. Sir, what is written? It told in the TCM not to turn stomach 36 much for children and adult too. Please, through. No. Even in the China, if you see the legs of the Chinese people, you will find the mark on the stomach 36 point because they are doing the regular marcivation on the stomach 36. Stomach 36 is removing the unwanted phlegm. We can always turn this point for creating the lots of energies. What point to use for breathing problems, COPD in the season due to heat and the pain in the backside lung area? We will discuss. Any treatment for the sneezing and coughing due to allergy? Tomorrow, we will discuss for the sneezing. How to find our body's heat or cold? Please give some ways to find. Okay, it need more time. We'll try to cover as much as possible.
Okay, now can I ask? Yes. Good evening. Thank you for your lovely presentation. It was really nice. And I have a little question that, you know, I got my second dose last Thursday. And after that, I have not had any temperature and anything, but I got a little scared because after meals, I feel very sleepy. I've not ever felt so sleepy anytime, but of late, I've been feeling very sleepy. But when I sleep and get up, I feel very fresh also. So is that an okay thing, or I got no temperature, I mean, no higher temperature or anything? So what would you say to that? And
So you feel sleepy after
vaccination? You feel sleepy all the time?
No, not all the time. Only after this vaccination, I think I've got the little change that I've got is I was feeling sleepy, and this is after 2-3 days of vaccination.
Yeah.
Okay. Otherwise, it is all fine. I'm attending all your sessions and everything. Yeah. But
okay.
So like today afternoon, I missed your thing because I felt sleepy.
Okay.
And there was no current, so I continued.
Okay.
So is that a sign? Yeah.
See,
we are during the illness. Body is creating lots of antibodies. So see, whenever any manufacture work is going on in the body, we definitely feel the sleepy. That's why baby sleeps for 20 hours in a day. Because in the baby who is very small, the newborn baby, he's sleeping for 20 hours, 22 hours, then slowly sleep is reducing 18 hours, 15 hours, 14 hours. Whenever any construction work is going on in the body, we feel sleepy. And even during the illness, we may feel sleepy. After the vaccination, if you feel sleepy for a few days, it is good. Nothing to worry. Wait for some time. It will be normal like earlier. So this is not any pathology. Uh-huh. It's just a normal thing. Normal body physiological functions, actions only.
Thank you for relieving that. And thank you for your session. Wonderful sessions. Thank you.
Manisha Mahinga.
Sir, I just spoke to you regarding the ingestion and the pain in my hand. You told about needling on the ears. But sir, I just know sujog. I don't know needling part, and I've never done.
Okay, fine. So don't worry.
Basic sujog, I know that also.
Tomorrow we will discuss the toxic heat attack on the body. That protocol you can apply in the sujog with the help of magnet. That within few days only you will feel good. Even with every single sitting, you will feel very good. Pain will disappear because this is some types of the attack of wind heat or toxic heat in the body. So with the help of that also, we can rectify this. Because for everything, for every disease, we can even work with the help of sujog. Sujog is also very wonderful. We can work with the help of sujog. Even we can work with the help of TCM. Even we can work with the needling or magnets. So tomorrow we will discuss the protocol. You can apply that.